Master calls.
Assisting the Redoran Guard with the Ashspawn attacks has earned you quite the reputation here. Keep it up. My apologies for doubting you, Sirio. I appreciate the help you've been giving us.
Keep moving.
On behalf of House Redoran and as Counselor of Raven Rock, I bid you welcome. I think it's important, but I couldn't really say. You've never heard of House Redoran? We're the mightiest of the great houses, and we lead the Council, the ruling body of Morrowind. My doors are open if you wish to discuss matters involving Raven Rock.
Yes? All right, then. Yes.
I'm glad you're here with me.
That's so sweet. I could tell you had that look in your eye. Hey, take it easy next time, will you? I can barely even breathe. Yes? Raven Rock, was it? The East Empire Company sure knows how to pick interesting names. There's a bit of irony there, as this settlement really is now more Dunmer than anything. Just look at just about anything. Looking at this place alone, I definitely feel this was someplace in Vardenfell. Tell you what, maybe, at least after all our adventuring in Skyrim is over, would you like to visit Morrowind? I've always wanted to go there. I always found their culture peculiar, but interesting. What happened to this town? It looks like it's seen better days. This better not... Ugh. Just do whatever you have to do. Ready when you are.
Not much contact with others around here. Got the Skull Village to the north, but the Nords there keep to themselves.
To oblivion and back, as they say.
Barkeep, I'd like a drink.
Of course.
Thanks.
A drinking competition. I imagine you'll do quite well.
Welcome to the Retching Niche Corner Club, home of the finest Sioux jammer that will ever grace your lips. Sure thing. It's yours for a day.
Oh, what is it?
Come back any time. My doors are always open.
I'm on it. Finished?
You and me.
Sure thing. Do you want to have it standing here, or do you want to find a seat first? All right. Now, do you want to have mead, wine, or just plain milk?
My favorite. You can never go wrong with a bottle of Kolovian vintage, no matter the occasion. Keep that weapon sharp.
What now?
Sure thing. Do you want to have it? Do you want to have mead, wine, or... Nice. Bit fancy now, aren't we? Likewise. Well, this is more of a unique and intimate journey in bed. I was just thinking about the last time
I swear, if I have to hear Ragnar the Red one more time,
besides
I will lose
how powerful
mind.
You are in combat, you truly are something else in bed. How you manage to have that much stamina and vigor. I don't know, but it keeps me wanting for more. What do you say? Let's go to bed later? I know. I was just thinking about Winterhold. When I was last there, it wasn't so crumbly. It used to be a sprawling city, everything being torn down, the whole place looking, well, dead. In fact, back in my day, the College of Winterhold would be the first place anyone would go for any kind of magic or historical thing. So, what do you want to talk about now?
Well, this one is a hard one. While I do like Ultmer wine, I would have to say the crown goes to Cyrodiilic brandy. The texture is just so unique. The flavors are strong, but not overpowering. And it sort of has a nutty, chocolatey aftertaste. Though it doesn't help that the brandy is so hard to find in Skyrim these days. All right. So, what do you want to talk about now? I have, actually. But not before I get to explore the rest of Tamriel. Besides those distant lands, there's a lot else to explore, you know? The delicacies and culture of Hyrok, the dense forests of Valenwood, the imperial city of Cyrodiil, or even Skyrim, by the Maker. I've spent most of my life cooped up in a dusty old tower.
Almost everything is new nowadays. All right.
There is a limit to how much history.
What do you want to talk about now?
Once, there is such a thing as sap poisoning. Some symptoms include gold tongue, where sap has left mouths golden at you.
Yeah.
Others have had their scales
It's not
to bark.
The most it's not comforting insane. Thought, but it's a reality I'll have to face eventually. Seeing as how I'm a vampire, my soul will most probably end up in Cold Harbor. If I could, though, I would like to potentially alter that fate. Don't get me wrong, I do enjoy my vampire powers, but I hate what it's done to my family, and who I ultimately have to submit to. All right. So, what do you want to talk about now? Wow. Looks like you're in a philosophical mood tonight. In terms of what I think, everyone is born as a blank slate. An infant, for example, doesn't know their right hand from their left. You can't hold them accountable for anything because they can't grasp the concept of what is good and what is evil. However, when you get to a certain age, you start learning these things. That's when people can start erring towards the more good part of the spectrum. Or quite the opposite. However, once you're on a certain end of this spectrum, it doesn't mean that you'll stay this way for the rest of your life. Some people rise as heroes and die as villains. Others, they work to overcome their evil with great effort. It's nice spending time like this, just having drinks together.
Right behind you.
Hey, so every corner of Skyrim seems to hide a surprise, doesn't it? Or a bandit. But hey, that's half the fun. Let's see what's next.
What now?
I thought you'd never ask.
Yes?
Hey, so I don't think this inn has beds for the both of us. It's all right. I'll just wait here.